Hi, my name is Peter Estrada. I work in tech support here at MSD Ignition. We're currently in the dyno testing area. We are going to discuss one of the most common topics that we run into every day in the tech department, which is troubleshooting PC to MSD communication issues when you're using a USB to serial port adapter. One of the biggest issues that we run into is either an improperly configured USB to serial port adapter or a missing driver. The driver is the software that interfaces the laptop with the actual USB device. One of the first things I want to cover is checking to see if the driver has been properly installed and configured. To do this, what we need to do is we go over to our computer, we click on the Windows logo down in the bottom left-hand corner, then we right-click on Computer or My Computer, depending on what version of Windows you're running. We left-click on Properties in the drop-down menu, which in turn should bring up the System Properties screen. This will help us identify what version of Windows we're running, whether it's a 32-bit or a 64-bit version, which will help us identify what driver we will need. Once we're in the System Properties screen, to the left-hand side, if you're running Windows Vista or Windows 7, there's a link that says Device Manager. When we click on the link, the Device Manager will be brought up to the front of the screen. At this point, what we're trying to identify is if the driver is configured or correctly or even installed at all. What we look for primarily is two things, either other devices or ports. Currently, the laptop that I'm looking at right now says other devices, USB serial controller D with a yellow exclamation mark next to it, which to me indicates that the device driver hasn't been installed or configured correctly. What we do is we double click on the USB serial controller and we will get a device status that says the drivers for this device are not installed. At this point, we click on the driver tab, then we click on the update driver button. We will be prompted with a wizard that's gonna ask us what we do next. Normally what we do is we've already downloaded the driver off of the internet for the appropriate version of Windows that we're running. So I'm going ahead and click on Browse on my computer for driver software. Then what I'm going to do is it gives me a path or location or the option to browse for the file. I go ahead and click on Browse. Since I've already saved it to the desktop, I'll just go directly to the desktop and locate the folder. Once I highlight the appropriate folder, I click OK. Then what I do is I go down to the next button and click Next. What the screen has just informed me is that Windows has successfully updated the driver software. We go ahead and hit close, then we hit close one more time on the actual property screen. Now, the USB adapter is being identified under ports, comm and LPT, and it's being identified as using comm 7. This is an important thing to remember because the MSD software looks for a specific range between 1 through 15, and that's another thing that can lead to problems with communication issues. What I primarily recommend before you start the MSD software is make sure the USB adapter is plugged into the computer for at least 20 seconds. What this allows it to do is the MSD graph view will identify available COM ports and it'll grab the one that it thinks is the correct one. We go ahead and open the MSD software in this case, which has never been configured, and it's asking us to select a COM port on the screen. The only option I have highlighted is COM 7. I left click on COM 7 and the MSD software will open. Now it says product connected, none, data source, none. This is an actual crucial step because there's also an option that says loopback test. In the event that it says loopback test, that means that the software for whatever reason grabbed the wrong COM port and it leads to other communication issues. In the event that it says loopback test, at this point we can go ahead and click on port, and it'll drop down all the COM ports and we make sure we have the correct COM port selected and that it is highlighted and communicating correctly. When you power up the ignition system, the MSD ignition should identify itself on the COM port and it should start transferring information from the MSD box onto the PC screen. Primarily what we want to do at this point is ensure that everything we've programmed is correct in the software. Once the MSD box has finished transferring all its data onto the screen, we pretty much know that the MSD box is communicating properly with the laptop. A few things that I would like to go ahead and hit on are you got to make sure you have the correct driver for that version of Windows. If you download a driver for Windows Vista and you have Windows 7 64-bit, the driver may not load correctly and it can lead to other issues. Another thing to remember about communication issues is that a lot of people find themselves in a hurry at the racetrack and they turn the software on before plugging in the USB adapter, which means the system doesn't see the port and it leads to further errors. If you find yourself still stuck or unable to resolve the issue, feel free to give us a call on our tech line, look us up on the web, send us an email, or contact us through the forums.